morning, whoever has joined me, I had to just start shooting this because I walked in and this is what was happening. A little bit more. There you go. Hey guys. Come here, I want to. My thinking is, if you stand at the back here, his feet are down close to the bottom of that window. What do you think? Oh, I know. We have 23 people watching. Good morning, everyone. We walked in this morning about 5 minutes ago, and I thought we had till about 8:30 or 9, and they were hoisting up the crucifix. My question is, how are they going to get that level up there? We've got we got Paul, the building foreman, the man himself up there on that top lift. Yeah, it's good. You're good. You're okay. No, you're fine right there. Sorry, folks. Shaking the camera around because I'm trying to communicate with Paul up there on the lift. Oh, good, they have a level up there. Oh, I like your comment, Ray. Lift high the cross, the love of Christ proclaim, till all the world can know His sacred name. Okay, it looks like they've got one cable attached. The cross itself is 16 feet long. The corpus is 9 feet tall. It's a I think it fits the space fairly nice. They're doing some detail work. Let's take a look at some of the detail in other parts of the church. All the wood is up. Looks like these guys are working to finish the choir rail up here. It's a really nice choir rail that's up there. Beautiful. Architects did a wonderful job designing this. One thing you will notice is all the canvas is off the concrete. So next week, we're going to get all this dust cleaned up and stain and polish this concrete. looks like they just about got one cable. That got one cable attached and tightened. It's two aircraft cable that are supporting this crucifix. Do you have Father Jacoby's mobile number? Won't you text him? Tell him I'm live streaming and he should come over here if he can. Thank you.
Sorry, folks.
Quite the scene on this Holy Saturday. Yeah, those of you that are on here, I got a call from Paul about 7:30 that said it was most likely to be between 8:30 and 9. We walk in here at 8:15, and they were hoisting this cross up. So, I don't know if you can tell, but at the bottom of that window, there's kind of the V that comes down. The reason they didn't hoist this thing up yesterday is because they wanted to get that marble work done, afraid that they'd be bumping into that crucifix trying to get that marble work done. So that got finished late yesterday afternoon. And you can check out on our Facebook page, the mosaic above the door outside was installed yesterday afternoon. So a lot happened on Good Friday. You can see that the niches have been, the marble's been installed in the niche. So pretty soon we're gonna see those statues of this side will be Joseph and Jesus, and the other side that you can't really see through that machine. Oh, yeah, you can, to the left of the machine. That's where Mary will go. Those statues are about a little over 6 foot tall. It's pretty amazing to be in this church right now because the workers have stopped working and they're watching this happen. Many of these workers are Hispanic, probably some of the same guys that put the icon of Saint Joseph in the front window. Painters painting the ceiling have stopped. The guys up there working on the railing, putting some finishing touches on that railing and getting it cleaned up. They're just kind of keeping an eye on this crucifix while they're doing their work. Let's see if we can, let's go over here and see if we can, there's some painters up there watching the action. Goodness. Okay. They're unhooking the yellow straps. So our aircraft cables are getting ready to be tested. Crucifix weighs about 330 pounds. Cross and corpus together. The crate it came in weighed almost that. Okay, I think he's up there with his level. I'm gonna go back. There's the rail up there. Again, the guy's working on the rail. There he is. Say good morning.
Good morning.
I'm sorry?
The feet.
The feet. Yeah, they're good. You're good. What I come back here, show you. They were going to put the bottom of the cross at the bottom of the V, and I thought, man, that's going to put him way high. Mm-hmm. So we put the bottom of the feet toward the bottom of the window. Because there's 3 foot between the feet and the bottom of that cross. Mm. Is it okay?
Yeah, it is. It looked a little long to me at the bottom.
Well, I think they've got, it's not that long.
Oh, okay.
They've got some... They got some cardboard over there to protect it.
Okay. Oh, there's Jane.
We're
going to run Paul's head into the ceiling. What's that? Yeah, you can go up there and look. Well, you can see because it's attached to the bottom of that beam that goes up. You can see there. So you can see how far out it is from that. It's actually a little further that way because the connect where it connects is on the sticks out from the front. And the reason it sticks out in front of the cross is because if you put the eyelets in the cross itself, the weight of the corpus would tilt it forward. So it has to be, it has, yeah, yeah. I know, that cable is. All that's left is to trim some of the cable. So there we have it. Wow. Okay, folks, I think that's it. I think that's, other than trimming those cables, I think it's a wrap. So, okay, until next time, God bless you all. Have a great, have a happy Easter, a happy Pascha. as the Eastern Church would say. God bless.